Welcome to Contact Today. We are continuing our series. It's called The Truth of the Gospel.
Wow.
Yeah. And
powerful.
Yeah, you can't ever stop. I mean, it's one of those things that just keeps expanding.
Right.
But we're hoping to lay out a simple foundation for you for the fact that the gospel is given for you to receive the gift of Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
As your Savior. That's really the gospel in a nutshell.
Yeah, and this is the most non-exclusive gift ever mentioned to mankind. You know how people are always talking about, well, there's certain people that can have something and other people can't? Well, that's not true of the gospel. So we want to show you today from the Word of God how the gospel of Jesus Christ is totally open and totally available to any human being. If you've got breath in your lungs, this applies to you, and you can have it for free.
We'll be right back.
Are you looking for a church that's active, engaged in outreach, and based on the biblical foundations of God's Word? If so, then Faith Landmarks Ministries is not only that, but much more. For over 35 years, Faith Landmarks Ministries has been teaching the Word of God, training up disciples, and expanding the kingdom. Through the fivefold vision God has given to Pastors Randy and Cherie, we make it our mission to fulfill the great commission that Jesus commanded in His Word. We invite you to come worship, receive, and fellowship with like-minded believers every Sunday morning at 8:30 and 10:30 a.m., Sunday evenings at 7 p.m., and Wednesdays at 7:30 p.m. Check out our website at faithlandmarks.org and view recent messages, see upcoming events, download study materials, and much more. You can also stay connected with us via any of our social media services. We invite you to come experience real, undoctrinated Christianity, where the Word of God is brought to life in you. We look forward to seeing you here at Faith Landmarks Ministries.
Welcome back. Just really glad again that you've joined us today on Contact. And what we're talking about on Contact today and for the next few broadcasts is what we have called the truth of the gospel. Now, we actually lifted that term out of the book of Galatians, the Apostle Paul using it to describe the gospel. And you've got a verse there in Romans that the
right.
gospel of Jesus Christ is the power of God unto salvation. So we want to let you know that Jesus died for everybody, and He is interested in you. And you need to understand there's nobody that has ever loved you like the Lord Jesus Christ. And so when you get to know Him and when you meet Him, it's the greatest experience that you will ever have of your entire life.
If you need more power in your life, the verse actually specifically, I just want to emphasize, Paul was talking to the Romans, and he said, I am not ashamed of the gospel. Why? I'm not embarrassed. I'm not timid. I don't mind standing up for Jesus in a society. And that doesn't mean I'm corny or out of date or any of that. I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ because, or it says for, it is, the gospel is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believes, to the Jew first and also the Greek, or meaning Jew or Gentile. So we're going to read a specific passage in the book of Acts where, you know, originally, you know, God made a covenant with Abraham, and the whole thing was based on the nation of Israel being God's chosen people. But even from that time, if you read the Old Testament, you'll see that God made a way really for strangers and foreigners, He called them, to receive, to be included in the covenant, even in those days. But then in the New Testament, He went ahead and sealed it by the Holy Ghost in an amazing story that we're going to read to you in just a few minutes. But like I said, if you just feel like your life is just sputtering along and you only want to see something begin to take place in your life, and it really doesn't matter how old you are, how long you've operated in a particular career or field, but if you want power, it's in the gospel. And the gospel starts with receiving Jesus as your Savior. And we explain why the gospel, what the gospel is. And then you receive the gospel into your life and you receive the power of God in
Right.
your life. And you actually are connected by birth to God. You become a new creature in Christ. You become in the bloodline of the Lord Jesus Christ. You become a joint heir with Jesus Christ of everything that belongs to God. And so all of this is available to you once you receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior.
And that's all because of the power of God that is in
the gospel.
The gospel of
yes,
Jesus Christ.
Right.
Now, so to the world that we live in today is increasingly more discriminatory, and these pressures of discrimination come on various people groups, different parts of the world, at different times and seasons. So it's not a new thing with God, because God understands why man, you have to understand that's man, that's not God, man is like that. Man is sectarian in nature. He's divisive. Often man is filled with hate. And none of those things are the nature of God. So you need to understand that God loves you, and His love transcends all barriers. There's not a human being on earth that God does not love. He loves you, and He cares about you. And He wants you to have eternal life in your life. Now, I have a verse that I want to read to you. Peter was one of Jesus's chosen, hand-picked, if you will, disciples. And in many ways, Peter sort of took the forefront in the four Gospels. There was Peter, James, and John, who were like a subgroup of the 12 disciples. And Jesus continually pulled Peter, James, and John to the side, and they included them in on various levels of training and truth that the others eventually got later. Okay, so Peter is one of the central figures in the New Testament. So the first part of the book of Acts is, it's basically the story of Peter and the other disciples meeting together after Jesus was raised from the dead, after He was taken up into heaven, and then God started the church through those early disciples. Now, but initially, because of the way they were culturally trained, they took God's plan for the nation of Israel. They took it and turned it into the kind of thing that man often does, excludes other people and et cetera.
This is why this story is so powerful, because, Peter was a blustery fisherman
right.
who got refined by spending time
right.
around Jesus. And actually people, when he preached, everybody was shocked because
yeah.
they knew he had never been to school.
He had never been educated.
No, and so they said, well, he must have been with Jesus because he certainly has changed.
Yeah.
But the thing about it is when the church was set up, the Pharisees, the scribes, the whole religious order was sure that the only people who were in the club
yeah.
were Jews.
Right.
You don't get in on this. You're not God's chosen people.
And then there was an inner club,
mm-hmm.
which turned out to be, the scribes, the Pharisees, the Sadducees, and the rulers
right.
of the synagogues.
All right. So, and maybe you've come across groups of people that are very cloistered and closed, exclusive and restricted.
Yeah. Sectarian.
Yeah. It's that we're exclusive and we restrict who
yeah.
can belong to our group.
And in the United States of America, it has come to light, which I believe is notable and should be taken notice of, that man discriminates against man based upon color of skin being one thing. That's just one.
Economic strata.
Yeah, there's several. Uh-huh. But anyway, getting back to the story.
Well, I want to say this and kind of set you up.
Okay.
But really, we have some hard heads here. And so...
talking about in the United States.
No, I'm talking about Peter.
Oh, okay. Right, okay.
Peter and James and John, and they were all under the impression that... And Jesus had said, don't, you know, just preach to the house of Israel. You know, just preach to the Jews.
Yeah, that was under his earthly ministry.
So it took a supernatural event to completely break open Peter's thinking for him to be able to accept the fact that the gospel was for every person.
Right.
So this is a setup for you to read this scripture, but it was an amazing incident. Peter had an angel visit him and said, three men are seeking you. He was in a trance. He was up on a roof. And this angel kind of had to kick him and wake him up and say, you know, these men are looking for you, and I want you to go with them. And so he basically, obeyed the angel.
Yeah.
And he had this vision.
It took him into uncharted territory because he had never been in the presence of Gentiles.
Anyway, unclean, you know.
Eating.
Taboo.
And, yeah.
Taboo. You know, it was
like
big taboos.
A Gentile's house.
All right.
And the guy was his name was Cornelius, and he was a Roman centurion. Mm-hmm. And so at any rate, when Peter got there, he was drawn in.
Supernaturally. He had to have an angel.
Right.
Saying, you need to go.
He was in the trance, which is, we call it being drunk in the spirit. So God had to get him drunk in the spirit to get him to accept the change. So he dropped his barriers. The angel was there.
He obeyed, even though it didn't make sense to his head.
The three men came, took him to Cornelius's house. And then when Peter got there, it's like, you know, Peter had already several times walked out of jail by these angels that were working with him. And so when it's the same thing. He's taken over to Cornelius's house. So the first thing that he says when he walks in the door, verse 34, Peter opened his mouth and said, of a truth, I perceive that God is no respecter of persons, meaning that God does not accept one person's person or individuality or identity or whoever they are. He doesn't accept one over the other. As far as God is concerned, we're all the same.
So just reading the next verse, I perceive that God is no respecter of persons, but in every nation, he that fears him or accepts him, believes in him, obeys him, and works righteousness is accepted with him. Now, in the first broadcast, I told the story of a person that I have a professional relationship with. They do some work for me at my house, and they were being, a shock factor that you need to get saved because the world's coming to an end in 30 days, and if you don't get saved, you're going to hell.
And that was probably 30 days ago.
No, it wasn't 30 days, but by the time this broadcast is out, it will have been the end of the world. So you might not get to see this. I'm not sure. But anyway, the Bible says that nobody knows the day or the hour. But if you write down these scriptures, Acts chapter 10, this is a wonderful story. Anyway, this man said to me, I help people. I give them food. I do things. And out of, I don't charge them. I help people. Does that count for anything? Well, it doesn't. But here's something that counted.
Yeah.
So this applies to people who have been involved in helping and feed people, giving, the Red Cross, any of those things. This is not the gospel. But here's something interesting. Verse 22 said, and they said, Cornelius the centurion is a just man and fears God and of a good report among all the nation of the Jews. He was warned from God by a holy angel to send for you into his house and to hear the words of you. Verse 31 says, Cornelius said, verse 30, 4 days ago I was fasting. At the ninth hour I prayed in my house, and behold, a man stood before me in bright clothing.
So an angel came to visit.
A Gentile.
Yeah.
Because here's what he said. Cornelius, your prayer is heard. Your alms are had in remembrance in the sight of God. So then the angel tells him to send for Peter. But guess what? That's not salvation.
Yeah.
But
it's just acknowledgement.
His charitable acts, yeah. The fact that he was looking to God so intently,
yeah,
that God set up this supernatural situation to send an angel to Peter to say, you know, bring down this four-cornered sheep three times and say, eat the crabs and eat the pork chops and eat all this, and Jews
which
didn't
very
do
well,
that.
The same thing could be happening right through this broadcast.
Exactly.
Is that there are people who have dedicated their lives to helping other people.
Public service.
Yeah, we know a lot of people in medical science and microbiology.
Community service, all those things. You know, first responders, works for the fire department.
Right, and they sacrifice their life.
But
and,
that's
and
not
sincere.
The gospel, yeah. And that's not salvation. And
right.
That does not give you any brownie points in heaven. There are no brownie points. Here's what it is. Peter opened his mouth and said, of a truth, I perceive that God is no respecter of persons. He went on to preach the gospel about Jesus Christ being Lord of all, and how God anointed him with the Holy Ghost.
Anointed Jesus.
With power, who went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed of the devil, for God was with him. And we are witnesses of all these things, that he was slain, he was hanged on a tree, and God raised him up the third day and showed him openly and to all people. And so then he said that he commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he, which was ordained of God to be the judge of the living and the dead, to him give all the prophets witness that through his name, whosoever believes in him shall have remission of sins. So God sent Peter through a supernatural intervention of angels to preach the gospel to this good man who feared God and did wonderful things to help people, but he was not born again. And because God had a plan to send Jesus to this earth, and go through coming in through birth of a virgin, to live a sinless life, to die on the cross and be raised again, all for the purpose that every person, whether they be a Jew, a Greek, whether they be rich or poor, tall or short, God is no respecter of persons. When you put your faith in his sacrifice, repent of your sinful state, and ask Jesus to be the Lord of your life, you are born again. Not what you do, not what you spend. It's a free gift, the Bible says. Now, let me read you a definition of respecter. It's also God shows no partiality. It means
right.
A face, a receiver of a face, one who takes sides, showing favoritism, exhibiting bias, showing discrimination, showing partiality, treating one person better than another. But while society makes distinctions, you know, among people, God's love and grace is available to every person.
Right.
On an equal basis, and it only is one thing required, that you believe in the sacrifice that Jesus paid for you personally, and that you accept his sacrifice, allow yourself to be washed in his blood, which cleanses you of all your sins, and then you become a child of God. You become the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. Old things are passed away. Behold, you have become a new creature. You've become born again. You've become a Christian.
Right. Now, so I've got a little excerpt here also from one of the Apostle Paul's sermons he was preaching. He actually preached this in Athens. He stood up in the most, as actually the most well-known place on earth for people to stand up and espouse various views, the Acropolis. And so he was there and he was preaching openly to the people that were there. And the Greeks, of course, were just, that nation was a nation, a pagan nation, meaning that they had many gods that they observed and they tried to follow. All right, so verse 26 of Acts chapter 17, the Apostle Paul made this statement. He said, "And God has made of one blood all nations of men for to dwell upon the face of the earth, and has determined the times before appointed and the bounds of their habitation." So God has made of one blood. Now, so the reason why we're telling you this is because we want you to understand that there are no racial or other types of restrictions,
right,
to anybody accepting Jesus as your Savior. You may have been raised as a Muslim. Door is wide open. Jesus is the same for every person, and so... you know, you might have been raised completely differently from this. But there are no closed doors for you to accept Jesus as your Savior. Now, in a moment, I want to pray with you to accept Jesus and be born into the kingdom of God. Now, it is an amazing thing that we can stand on planet Earth, and I'm going to lead you in this simple prayer, but by virtue of these words, what you're going to be doing is expressing verbally your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. And then you're going to say with your mouth, this is what the Bible calls confession, you're going to say that Jesus is Lord. Okay, so if you would, just follow me in this simple prayer. Just say this with your mouth. I believe in my heart that Jesus is raised from the dead. Hmm. Lord Jesus, I call you my Lord and my Savior. Lord Jesus, wash me in your precious blood. Cleanse away all sin. I accept you today as my Savior in the name of Jesus. And from today forward, I will identify myself. I will call myself a Christian. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
God,
a Christian.
Yeah.
Not any other name.
Not any other
name. It makes
name.
It so simple,
yeah.
You know.
I'm a Christian now. Yeah.
And then, you know, the gospel is just the first step. The gospel, this is the gospel.
Right.
After the gospel then becomes discipleship, where
right.
you begin to learn what it means to, you get your mind renewed by getting to know God through the Word of God.
Right. And which is why, see,
we only have
a few seconds left, so we want to make sure
back.
That you have the opportunity mm-hmm. to get this free gift. We want to give you this little book. It's called What Jesus Did for You at Calvary. It's five basic things that Jesus died at Calvary to give you, and all the scripture references pertaining to that. It's a good first step of discipleship. And we got instructions at the bottom of the screen. All you got to do is follow those instructions, and this will belong to you. We want to say that we love you and appreciate
you. And we'll be right back. We just have a short little close, and we'll see you in just a minute.
Contact TV is focused on seeing you live a victorious life in Christ. For air dates and showtimes, visit our website at contact.tv. Join us and see how to live in the abundant life Jesus has made available for you. Providing 2 years of extensive learning, FLBI is passionate about bringing your walk with God to the next level. Experience FLBI on the go. With FLBI Online, you can access your curriculum and take lessons at any time of the day on your computer, tablet, or smartphone. Video-recorded lessons from our FLBI instructors provide a virtual classroom experience that allows you to study wherever you are. Online classes are available year-round. For a limited time, you can take full FLBI courses at no charge. Register online at flbi.org to get started. Don't miss this limited time offer. Make the spiritual investment to grow in your knowledge of the kingdom.
It's great that you've joined us today. It's possible that while we were describing the salvation experience, that you decided on the inside of you that you would like to do that now as well. So I can lead you in a simple prayer. It's also a confession of faith. And you can be born into the family of God right now. You can be saved. You can have your sins washed away. You can become a new creature. All of the terminology means the same thing. You can be born again. You can be saved right now. Now, it's very simple. Just follow me in this. Say this with me. Lord Jesus, I believe in my heart that you are raised from the dead. Lord Jesus, I confess you as my Lord. I call you my Lord. Lord Jesus, come into my life, wash away all of my sin, cleanse me of all unrighteousness. I accept you today as my Savior. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. So we're really glad that you've been with us today on Contact, and join us again.
Download your copy of What Jesus Did for You at Calvary by scanning the QR code on the screen or by visiting contact.tv. This download is available in multiple languages.
Welcome back. Really glad that you're with us, have been with us on Contact. We just have a few seconds left, but we want to make sure that you have the opportunity to get this little book into your house, your life. There's two different ways you can do it. It's right at the bottom of your screen. You can either have it sent to your house, or you can actually just download the thing right onto your phone by clicking on or taking a picture of that QR code that's on the screen. So we love you, we appreciate you, and we look forward to seeing you again on Contact. This is a discipleship book.
Right. Yeah. You know, in Christ, there are no barriers. And so it's just a wonderful time of liberty and freedom to just step into becoming a Christian. So if you ask Jesus into your heart, we'd love to hear from you. Please send us an email. Let us know you've made that decision. And we want to rejoice with you. See you back next time.